Hey, Jeff from Become More Compelling here. Welcome to another episode of Compelling Breakdowns. So today I'm going to break down Will Ferrell in a few different situations where he is being witty in conversation. Because that's our topic today, is how to be witty in conversation. The skill of being funny, being witty in conversation is super important. When you meet a new person at work, if you're able to crack a joke, that shows a lot of things. It shows like, hey, this person doesn't take themselves too seriously. This person has a good sense of humor. And it's giving off all these really good kind of tells for someone who is socially skilled. That's what we're gonna cover today. Let's dive in. So I chose Will Ferrell for a specific reason. A lot of times when he appears on late night TV, he is a little extra. So he'll dress up as a leprechaun, like all kinds of crazy stuff. I'm not gonna show you any clips like that. I picked the most subdued clips of Will Ferrell I could find. And so you can be low-key witty, low-key funny, and still have a good outcome. So we're gonna cover three things that Will Ferrell does really well: juxtaposition, left turn stories, and breaking a pattern. So let's dive into the first clip.
Thanksgiving.
Is it not yet?
No.
Coming up.
No, today is Thanksgiving.
It is?
Yeah, today. Happy Thanksgiving.
Hey. Thanks for coming over.
Thanks for coming over,
did
man.
Did you make any food?
I have just liquids. I just pureed some turkey and stuff.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. All right, what are coming you doing up for Thanksgiving? Anything cool?
Yeah, super cool stuff.
Yeah.
Hold on. Look at this. I'm going to the house where my wife grew up in Boston.
There you go, man.
To hang out with my mother-in-law.
Wow.
And they have a basement.
Wow.
And
wow, that's fun.
We're gonna be, yeah.
Kids must love that.
The kids love it. The kids do. They love going to Boston,
yeah.
Because there's no basements in California. Houses don't have basements.
That's
so
right.
A basement is like a magical place for them.
Yeah, and, sure. Like
they can, yeah, go down there and, you know, have Nerf gun battles and.
Yeah.
So right there, Jimmy Fallon asks Will Ferrell if he's doing anything fun for Thanksgiving. And what Will Ferrell does is he juxtaposes the kind of the boring story of like, oh, you know, my family and I are just going to Boston to hang out with our in-laws. He juxtaposes that with, oh, I'm doing some fun stuff. You're not gonna believe this.
Yeah, super cool stuff.
Yeah.
Hold on, look at this.
And he sells it as being a super interesting story, even though it's pretty mundane what he's actually doing. And so right there, The key when it comes to being witty is you can juxtapose things. So say that you did something really exciting, like you skydiving. So say that you did something really exciting like that. Oh, what'd you do this weekend? Oh, you know, it was pretty boring. Like we went up on this plane and we jumped out of the plane. So you're juxtaposing different emotions. You're combining excitement and selling an amazing thing to a boring or a mundane story. And you know ahead of time, like, okay, I'm selling this as a exciting thing, and that's the joke. The joke is two things that don't fit together. I'm fitting them together. And skydiving example, oh, I'm selling it as a really boring story, except that it's super exciting. And so anytime you can juxtapose different emotions, things that shouldn't fit together, that's what makes something witty. That's what makes something funny.
And then the other big thing we do is we go to Dunkin' Donuts.
When you're in Boston?
Their uncle, my brother-in-law.
Yeah.
My wife's brother.
Yeah.
Takes them to Dunkin' Donuts, and they get to just pick whatever they want.
That's what you do when you go to
so
Boston?
That's what happens.
Wow.
When we go to Boston.
Ow!
Yeah.
Woo!
And so he wraps up that story with, like, and that's what happens when we go to Boston. And the joke is, okay, I know I just told you something that was really boring, but I am selling it like it's really exciting. And that's a nice little tagline at the end of that story. Really basic story, could have been a trip to Home Depot, could have been anything, but selling it as something that's exciting, that puts a fun, witty twist on that story. All right, let's look at the next clip.
I saw you at the Australian Open.
Yes, last week.
Yeah, you were there.
I was down in Melbourne, Australia, to go watch the tennis match, the Australian Open. So, it's one of the Grand Slams.
Yeah,
there's
absolutely.
Four.
Roger Federer.
U.S. Open, Wimbledon, Jamaican Open, and the Australian Open.
They don't do the Jamaican Open anymore. They got rid of that one.
Okay, so here he establishes a pattern. When he talks about going down to the Australian Open, he's like, okay, there are four Opens. There's Australian, US Open, Jamaican Open. He established a pattern and then he broke that pattern.
So it's one of the Grand Slams.
Yeah,
there's
absolutely.
Four.
Roger Federer.
US Open, Wimbledon, Jamaican Open.
Everyone who follows tennis at all knows that there's not a Jamaican Open, and that's what makes it funny. He, again, put something that shouldn't belong in a pattern of things that belong together. And that's the joke. So anytime that you can, if you can establish a pattern, and the rule of threes really applies here. So if you can make the first two, you know, just normal, like I went to the store and I got bread, milk, and a salamander. That last thing doesn't fit with those other two. So anytime you can break that pattern, that's automatically gonna make whatever you were saying a little funnier. And what's interesting too is if you notice, he doesn't laugh very much at his own jokes. Like, I think it's okay to be enthusiastic. Like, I covered Bill Hader in a previous episode and he was just cracking up at his own story. And I think there's a time and place for that. But if you're trying to be witty in conversation, the less you can laugh at your own jokes, the better. He does give this kind of sly smile where you understand that, like, okay, he's joking. He knows he's joking. And it's like, it's almost like he just got away with something because he inserted that break in the pattern and he made everyone laugh.
But you saw McEnroe?
I got called onto the court by John McEnroe.
I love John McEnroe.
To help conduct his interview with Roger Federer.
This is, if you haven't seen this, guys, check it out on YouTube. It's
but
one
I,
of the funniest things.
I did it as Ron Burgundy.
And Roger Federer, we've done yeah. bits about him. I don't know if he really is a comedy fan. He must love comedy, but I don't know.
He's a sweetheart, but he's very Swiss.
Yes, he's very, and, he's all business. Did he know that anything
well, no,
was
no, he didn't know what was happening. So when I walked out onto center court, much like the way the heckler just ran onto the...
There's no security there.
There's no security, and he doesn't know what's going to happen. And his body language is like...
You start
and
asking
so
crazy questions.
Asking,
you said you've been in this, you've been playing...
You're 36, Roger, let me ask you this. You're 36 years old.
Yeah.
You're defying the laws of age. Are you a witch or a vampire?
How did he answer that one?
He said, they both sound terrible.
And those two options, like, they're breaking the construct of, like, okay, what's your secret? You know, do you eat a lot of healthy food? Do you practice every day? So it's fitting those two options, which are just ludicrous options, into just a normal question about an aging tennis player still playing at the top of his game. And this is another juxtaposition thing. So if you can put a couple of different options that are both jokes, right? So the witch or vampire, like those are your two options and those are obviously just jokes. Anytime you can fit a couple of options that don't fit in a normal question, that can be good for a little witty throwaway joke where you're giving a couple of ludicrous options to someone. And that's what makes it funny. And you're building a lot of tension by asking the question. And then when people realize, like, oh, it's a joke, that releases the tension. And that's what makes it funny. All right, let's watch the next clip.
Here was an amazing, a great Hollywood moment. You finally get to go to the Oscars. You're all dressed up. You're excited. The red carpet, it's more photographers than you can ever imagine.
Sure.
And they're screaming your name. Will, over here. Will, over here. And you're looking at the cameras. You can't look any more directly than you are looking. And I'm like, I'm looking at you. I'm looking. And they're like, Will, over here. Will, over here. I'm like, I'm looking at you. I'm looking. And I finally look to my left, and it's Will Smith. And I go, I go, oh. And we just started laughing so hard.
That's wonderful.
And just, let's get out of here. Let's go.
They got enough of
us. They got enough of us. Mm-hmm. They want the real Will.
Okay, so Ferrell's doing something I call a left turn story. So he is making you believe that, like, okay, he was at the Oscars and people were screaming his name, and he really sells it very well in this clip because he's mimicking the photographers that are like, Will, Will. And he's like, I'm looking right at you. And he has a little bit of repetition to really sell the premise of the story. And then he's like, and then I look to my left and it was Will Smith and they were yelling for him. And that is the left hand turn story. So for the entire story, you're going in one direction and then at the last possible second, it makes a sharp turn. And so it's the things that led up to that moment, you realize that it was completely different. So if you want to be witty in conversation, anytime you can lay in a left-hand turn story, it is super effective. So it could be anything. The pattern is simply like, okay, if I'm telling the story, how can I make the audience believe that one thing is going to happen and then at the last second, the opposite thing happens. And then boom, you've got yourself a left turn story. All right, so that is it. That was a quick primer on how to be witty in conversation. Our key points to remember, juxtaposition. So anytime you can fit two things that shouldn't fit together, that's always gonna make for something really funny. You've got pattern breaking. So anytime you can have, especially a group of three and the first thing, the second thing, and then the third thing just doesn't make any sense or just doesn't belong in that place on that list, then that's gonna be very witty. And then you've got your left turn story where you make the audience think one thing and then it ends up being the opposite thing in the end. Those are three ways to be witty in conversation. All right, that is it for me. If you have a breakdown that you'd like me to do, you can send them over to me at the Jeff Callahan on Instagram or Twitter. You can drop a comment below the like button, or you can just send me an old-fashioned email at jeff@becomemorecompelling.com. So don't forget to gently hit the like button. We don't want to break it. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you on the next one. Talk soon. Hey, a couple of quick things before you leave. One, I've got a subscribe button over here. If you like this video and you don't want to miss out on a future video, hit that subscribe button. Two, if you like this video, hit the like button. That helps other awesome people like you find it. And three, leave a comment if you have any feedback for me or if you have a topic or suggestion that you want me to cover in a future video. Thanks.